And there's a hell of a lot going on this week here on Wildside.
Who's behind them? The One Man Mafia. Bad news for Sweet Dreams. And bad news for his spine.
Power bombed out of his shoes.
10,
and his cornrows.
9, 8, 7.
But Gabriel's still fighting back.
Five,
back to the man that
four,
we know he is.
3, 2, 1.
Never say die.
One. Number 11 this evening is Chance Profit.
And Chance Profit, a man who's impressed many a wrestling promoter throughout the United States, and most recently in NWA TNA, sees an opportunity here to get at the World TV Championship. But he's got to go through Gabriel, Michael Adrian, Sweet Dreams, and Jason Blackman in order to do it. Best of luck, Mr. Profit.
And this time, Profit showing his face here.
Yeah, he was in the paint the last time.
Normally comes to the ring adorned in the black and white face paint, but tonight decides that he'll let his identity be known to the wrestling world.
Gabriel saw an opportunity to try to hoist Michael Adrian over that top rope. But that is indeed one of the tallest orders in the business. And Sweet Dreams with a fist in the face of Blackman. Chance Profit with a few and Michael Adrian. And Michael Adrian responds in kind with a high knee. And Chance Profit, at this rate he's going, will be non-profit. Oh, I'm full of them.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Sounds like the feature presentation is about to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, the feature presentation, Jeff Lewis.
And Jeff Lewis successful in hoisting Sweet Dreams over that top rope.
Sweet Dreams has been eliminated.
And Jeff Lewis, we have not seen him here for a few weeks. If Jeff Lewis is able
Chance
to keep his mind off JC North.
Has been eliminated from the Mega Rumble.
If Jeff Lewis is able to keep focus on the card here at hand and keep his mind away from JC North, I think Jeff Lewis has a genuine chance of becoming number one contender for the World TV title.
Certainly.
I really think so.
Certainly, but he's got to fend off the challenge of JC North. JC North, a man who's coming up later in this matchup, he didn't even enter himself into this contest until he knew Lewis was already in. Lewis is trying to move past JC North. JC North wants revenge for Lewis cracking his bald pate on that post out there.
5,
well,
so obviously
we'll be seeing JC North later on in this Mega Rumble.
One.
All right,
wait
now! Whoa!
Boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, JC North!
And Jeff Lewis makes a beeline out of the bottom rope. JC North with a flying body press on Michael Adrian and slapping the crap out of Jason Blackman.
Well, Lewis got out of sight. He got North distracted and snuck right up behind him.
And true to form, now Jeff Lewis now paying total attention to JC North. And North and Lewis fisticuffs aplenty between two people who hate each other perhaps more than any of the two athletes here at Wildside. Big chop from North, and Lewis is reeling. As Adrian and Blackman seemingly have Gabriel ready to be thrown over that top rope.
Boy, Gabriel's hanging on for dear life over there, Steve.
And North choking the life of left of it out of Jeff Lewis.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drawing number 14, Jeremy B.
Perhaps the man who might be the hungriest out of all the athletes we've seen so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, JC North and Jeff Lewis have both been eliminated.
And JC North, I think, purposely sacrificed himself in order to keep going at Jeff Lewis. Talk about a man on a mission. Not quite the mission of the World TV title, but hell.
Well, North did it to prevent Lewis from getting that opportunity, and anything he can do to cause misery in the life of Jeff Lewis, he's happy with. But now Jeremy V, the next participant in the ring, one of the odds-on favorites here from a standpoint of he's a guy that will never give up. But you got to look at the rules of a battle royal. A guy the size of Jeremy V is really at a disadvantage because the big guy, the guy with the big center of gravity like Adrian, is your favorite because it's going to be harder to dump him over the top. But don't ever discount the fighting spirit of Jeremy V. There's the VKO on Adrian in the corner. He pinned Jason Cross 2 weeks ago on Wildside. Who thought
10,
he could do that?
9, 8, 7.
That's true.
Six,
frankly, I'm very Adrian.
Probably
his
three,
first and foremost
two,
is to make sure that
one.
Jeremy V does not progress any further in this.
Participant 15, Drew Blood.
And Drew Blood coming out to the strains of Duran Duran. He's got a lot of nerve. I'll tell you. And Drew Blood now putting the boots to Jeremy V, accompanied by Jason Blackman. Michael Adrian, boys, had to endure some major punishment from V. And Gabriel trying to gather what few wits he has left. V fighting back for all he's worth, and we know that's plenty. Very clever on the part of V.
Drew Blood sneaking in the neck breaker there.
Drew Blood finding himself to be a bit of a dark horse among the athletes in the ring at the moment.
He's definitely hungry.
But stranger things have happened in professional wrestling.
To talk about the size disadvantage that V has, what about Drew Blood? What about that spine buster there by Jason Blackman?
I think it busted up the back of the head of Jeremy V just as much as it did the spine.
Seven,
you see V's head
six,
go bouncing off
five,
the mat.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Biohazard.
And Biohazard, a man who's shown so much improvement over the span of the last few weeks here at NWA Wildside, is getting an opportunity to show a lot of improvement on quite a number of athletes. Biohazard reporting a lot of his fans here tonight.
He's a guy that the people are really starting to get behind. And how can you blame him? He's shown tremendous effort week in and week out, win or lose. This guy comes here to fight, and he gives it everything he's got.
Good, he's going to need it here tonight.
People can identify with a guy like that. And Biohazard, really a great, tremendous up-and-comer. What an opportunity it is here for him tonight.
And Jason Blackman with a handspring elbow on Jeremy V and a high knee.
10,
and
9,
V is rocking.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
and Michael Adrian
2,
committed to
1.
Do some more damage to Gabriel before perhaps throwing him over that top rope.
Throwing number 17, Cool Seth DeLay.
And Seth DeLay just dumped Biohazard out. Biohazard, unfortunately, making the rookie mistake
Ladies
of not paying
and gentlemen,
attention.
Drew Blood has been eliminated, as has Biohazard.
Never turn your back in a battle royal facing the ropes, but let's look at the statistics in here, Steve, right now. As far as time, Michael Adrian has to be in here the longest. He was the earliest man surviving at this rate. Gabriel the second longest, and it's Gabriel that's taken the most punishment but still fighting back against Seth DeLay.
Gabriel's been in there for quite some time, as has now Jeremy V. And Seth DeLay, easily the freshest man here, but Gabriel fighting back for all he's worth. And a swift kick from Cool Seth DeLay, as Adrian shooing DeLay away.
10.
And DeLay keeping Adrian
eight,
from his
seven,
job, his purpose
six,
here tonight.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, participant number 18 is unrated Salvatore Rignaro.
And the match is suddenly headed south. And Salvatore Rignaro showing that he's no fluke. With a forearm leveling the Archangel, Gabriel, and now Rignaro paying his attention to Jeremy V.
Rignaro actually getting off of his butt and wrestling for once. It's
come to this, huh?
Rarity these days, but wouldn't be in this matchup if he didn't have an agenda. Maybe he feels that the old two is better than one motto. Maybe the The two guys that totally rule are the former G-rated or whatever the hell it is that he's calling themselves these days. Maybe the teamwork is the key. Maybe they're going to try to co-become number one contender. What do you think of that?
What? Based on the fact the other members of the matchup at this moment are
10,
Jeremy V,
9,
as well as Jason
8,
Blackman, Gabriel, and Michael Adrian,
6,
I think the issue
5,
of the reunited G-rated is it might be a moot point.
2,
forgive me.
1.
I'm not playing favorites here.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ray Gordy.
And Ray Gordy has certainly changed the complexion of this Mega Rumble. And Salvatore Renara now going after his former hire, Ray Gordy, and accompanied by Seth DeLay.
A lot of bad blood still there. Gordy has not even come close to forgiving Renaro for that whole escapade. Oh, whirly bird there by Jason Blackman.
Hey, I tell you, I think about the most impressive outfit we've seen so far in this Mega Rumble, the most impressive effort, I think, comes from Jason Blackman. And he's not the man that most people would have guessed.
He's certainly been fighting his heart out here.
Yeah.
You got to give it to Gabriel, though, for taking as much punishment as he has and still being in the match.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drawing lucky number 20, Caprice Ace Coleman.
Now, obviously, Caprice Coleman is obviously going to be under one of Michael Adrian's other main targets to be wiped out here, so he's not put any contention with Jason Cross for the World TV title. But with all the goodness, Caprice Coleman with an enzugiri, dropping Jason Blackman like the proverbial bad habit.
Renaro thumps Coleman in the eye there. Off the ropes, high back body drop. Renaro goes down. We got Blackman and Gordy brawling over here. There's a twisting fisherman's buster by Gordy. DeLay, Seth DeLay on the cusp of elimination here.
But DeLay holding on for dear life to that top rope. And getting his body tangled up within the rope too, saving his. Blackman hanging on. I'm putting a kick, swift kick to the face of Ray Gordy. When Ray Gordy came so dangerously close to being eliminated right there, I think Blackman thinks that Gordy is eliminated. And unfortunately,
Blackman has been eliminated.
And Sal Renaro from behind.
Gordy has been eliminated from the Mega Rumble.
Rob Ray Gordy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Archangel Gabriel and the one-man mafia, Michael Adrian, have also been eliminated.
Well, Gabriel sacrificed himself right there. Gabriel sacrificed himself. It was Adrian put in the match specifically to eliminate the guys that the Elite had a hit out on. Gabriel was one of them. Coleman and Jeremy V were the other. Gabriel very close with Coleman and V. He took the hit for his friends there. He got Michael Adrian out of the match, the biggest threat to Caprice Coleman and Jeremy V. Now Jeff G. Bailey, the entire threat of the next number one contender is in the hands against him of G-rated Salvatore Renaro, Cool Seth DeLay. It's up to them to protect Jason Cross's World Television Championship.
So you mean that Jeff G. Bailey needs a new pair of underwear right now?
Definitely.
Well, that's quite interesting here, because now Jason Cross has got to be an awful bit concerned here, too. Boy, Cool Seth DeLay, whoa! Came within centimeters of being eliminated. And Caprice Coleman hanging on also for dear life.
Coleman skins the cat.
Cool Seth DeLay has been eliminated. As has unrated Salvatore Renaro. Remember, the rules change now. It is a standard singles one-on-one matchup, pinfall and submission rules.
And that's Jeremy V versus Caprice Coleman. Jeremy V, at one time, made the world, at the end, World TV champion Rain Man tap out in the War Games. Caprice Coleman, a former World TV champion himself, a man who wants that title back probably more than anything on this planet.
And here we go. fate has brought them here. Their abilities will carry them beyond this. Jeremy V, Caprice, Ice Coleman, two very close friends, two men that would take a bullet for one another, but now the number one contendership is at stake. They know what's at stake. They're going to compete for it. May the best man win.
And the best man between these two people, well, it's anyone's guess. Neither of these two athletes has any distinct advantage that we know of going into this matchup. The only thing I might consider perhaps might be in Caprice Coleman's favor is that Jeremy V's been involved in this Mega Rumble for a longer period of time. What damage has been done during that time is only up to Jeremy V.
Definitely, and if you look in the past at the high-profile marquee matches, Jeremy V's won his share, but he's also been defeated in many key points, so is Coleman. So they're very even there. One would probably favor Coleman just because he has officially been World Television Champion. That's something that V has not. Coleman very hungry because he's been robbed out of that title time and time again. V very hungry because he was also robbed out of it. You look back last year, he was the uncrowned television champion. He beat Rain Man in a cage match at a non-televised event, and the tape mysteriously disappeared. Therefore, the ruling was overturned. It wasn't airable on television, couldn't be a TV title match. Northern Lights suplex there by Caprice Coleman. He hangs on, brings V back up, takes him back over again in rotation. Look at the agility by Coleman, rolls back through again, but V is fighting, trying out of this. Wait a minute, inside cradle, here we go. Reversal two.
Opportunities and great luck can change within 3 seconds, as we've seen innumerable number of times here at NWA Wildside. Two of the classic Wildside athletes, two of the most gifted men who've ever walked down the ramp of the NWA arena, are competing for number one contendership to the World TV Champion.
And there's the elevated flatliner, high impact maneuver. And a big coup for Coleman this early in the matchup. Coleman hooks the legs. He's shoulder up at the last second.
Last possible fraction of a second there too. Now Jeremy V has seriously been slowed down by Caprice Ice Coleman, as well as other damage he's been leveled against him previously on in this 20-man Mega Rumble. Now it is a traditional pro wrestling matchup. Coleman on top for the pin attempt. Only a two count. V fighting back. The crowd evenly split behind between their devotions to these two athletes. I think the throng here at the NWA Arena would be delighted if either of these two athletes would become number one contender. No doubt about it.
Definitely. Jeremy V, there's the VDT. 20 pin Jason Cross with 2 weeks ago. Early in the contest, though, for Coleman, and he knows it. Jeremy V's going to try to add a little topping onto that pizza. Going to the top.
V heading up to the top rope. Did it somewhat slowly.
Goes for his 450 splash, the flying V. He does nail it.
V, that's a very, very great name for that. One of the classic guitars and one of the now classic wrestling moves in professional wrestling in the year 2004. Unfortunately for Jeremy V, Caprice Coleman got his knees up in time. Since the amount of time that Jeremy V took to pull that one off was in Coleman's favor, obviously.
Coleman going for thermal shock here. No. Thinks different, goes for the comatoser here. Now, V drops V on his head. This is the end here. No, V rolls through. Sunset flip. He's got it. V wins.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, and now the new number one contender to the World Television Championship, Jeremy V.
An incredible accomplishment from V. And par for the course.
Now, damn
it. Here comes the NWA Elite.
Come on.
What Michael Adrian was sent into this Mega Rumble to do, he was not able to accomplish, so perhaps they can accomplish it after the match is over.
There's the assisted suicide on Coleman. Now, come on.
And Cross just brainbustered Jeremy V. And Jeff G. Bailey responds with a slap, too. I mean, Caprice Coleman, now no longer in the World TV title picture. Good heavens! Here comes Gabriel with a chair.